Let us now study about frequency modulation, which is also abbreviated as FM. As we already discussed in amplitude modulation, that the amplitude of a carrier wave is modified with the modulation by baseband signal. Here we can write that in frequency modulation, frequency of carrier wave is varied according to the baseband signal. Here you can see if we are having a baseband signal or a modulating signal, as YM is equals to AM sine of omega MT, and we are given with the high frequency carrier wave. We know that baseband signal is a low frequency signal and carrier wave is high frequency, at which is given at YC is AC sine of omega CT. In previous section of amplitude modulation, we have studied that the amplitude of carrier wave was modulated by mixing of baseband signal. Here in frequency modulation, we don't change the amplitude of a carrier wave, but the frequency of carrier wave is modified with the mixing of baseband signal. So here, if the two are supplied into a phase modulator, into a frequency modulator, this frequency modulation output will be YFM, which is given as AC sine of the frequency omega C is modified as, this can be written as 2 pi. If I take omega C as 2 pi FC, if FC is the frequency in hertz of the carrier wave, this is written as 2 pi, and we write it FC plus KF times the baseband signal, that is AM sine of omega MT multiplied by T. So you can see this is the frequency modulated signal where we have changed the frequency of carrier wave FC by mixing it with the baseband signal. So all the information of baseband signal is mixed with the frequency of this frequency modulated signal, which can be extracted at the reception end. And here this parameter KF, which is a proportionality constant used for baseband signal to be added with the frequency for matching with the unit, also is called frequency modulation index. Like we already taken up the amplitude modulation index as the ratio of amplitudes of baseband signal to that of the carrier wave. Here this is the FM index, frequency modulation index, which when one multiplied with the displacement of baseband signal, it will give us a frequency which is varying with the baseband signal added to the carrier frequency. Now here the mixing can be done in the way here you can see. This diagram here shows the frequency modulation process. If this is the device we call FM modulator, from one side if baseband signal is supplied into, and from other side carrier wave is supplied into it, it gives an output of frequency modulated signal, where you can see the modulated signal has amplitude that of carrier wave, because as we have discussed above, that the amplitude modulated wave has amplitude AC, but its frequency is varying according to the information in baseband signal. In next page, on next page we can understand how this frequency modulated signal contains the information of baseband signal when it is superimposed on a carrier wave. Let's continue. Let us now understand the waveform of frequency modulated wave, as on the previous sheet we have discussed how frequency modulation takes place. In this, the information contained in the baseband signal is imposed on the frequency of carrier wave. Here you can see the point where the displacement of a baseband signal is maximum. That is the point where we can see the frequency of the frequency modulated signal is maximum, and the points where the displacement of baseband signal is minimum, Due to this, the frequency of frequency modulated signal is minimum. This is the way how the frequency varies in the frequency modulated signal. In the situation here, we can see the frequency continuously varies in frequency modulated signal according to the information in baseband signal. The points where the displacement in baseband signal is zero, at that point the frequency in the amplitude modulated signal is at the carrier frequency. So this is the point, this will be another point where we can see the frequency will be equal to carrier frequency because the displacement of baseband or modulating signal is zero. So it will not be varying the frequency of carrier wave. But at all other points, so wherever the displacement of baseband signal is positive, the frequency of frequency modulated signal will be higher than omega c. And at all the points wherever the displacement of modulating signal or baseband signal is negative, the frequency of modulated wave is less than omega c. So this is the way how the frequency of FM wave contains all the information of the baseband signal. Here you can see the frequency of FM signal varies very close to the carrier frequency. So the antenna size required for this wave to be transmitted will be practically small, and the average frequency is very high in FM signal. It can be easily transmitted with a sufficient radiation power.